doesn't. Children are always a blessing, and they are to be brought to Christ in baptism. But the means that God appointed for procreation can so easily be misused and perverted. But the world makes children to be the problem, not the sexual immorality that also leads to children, as it does within marriage. But what does the scripture say? But because of the temptation of sexual immorality, each man should have his own wife, and each woman her own husband. But our world teaches these things are optional, marriage and children. But what leads to them, it's not. God built this attraction, this urge, this driver to marriage into our bodies. We don't have to teach this to our kids. And when these things are kept together along with marriage and children, then families and societies are strong. But when they are separated, marriage and children are made to be a burden, women are hurt, families are broken apart, and sexual immorality destroys souls. We see that all around us. But what does the Lord say? Flee from sexual immorality. Every other sin a person commits is outside the body. But the sexually immoral person sins against his own body. But our God did not make a mistake in making us. There's nothing wrong with our bodies or how they function. The problem is us. How we look at others, how we use others and our own body against God and His will. Though people often speak like this, there is no actual trying to have a child. God did all the work in making us male and female. And He continues to work in conceiving new life. Children are God's work, not ours. In fact, a husband's and wife's part in conceiving new life is so minuscule that we can't take credit for it. We can't boast about it. But yet, due to sin, we misuse our bodies and our minds. Our hearts and wills are turned away from God, and we take what is a great gift and turn it into a curse. So life is tolerated if we have to, but not embraced, not loved, as God demands. He demands much more, that we love all He has made and all that He makes. God loves us, and so He tied children to marriage. God is not cursing marital relations. He blesses husband and wife. That is His own word. And God blessed them. And God said to them, be fruitful and multiply and fill the earth and subdue it. God sends children like the rain. Whether people want or think about them, whether they ask for children, He sends out His blessings, an unbeliever and believer alike. But this extraordinary gift is hated and despised and avoided by sinners. In theory, of course, everyone loves babies, but they're thinking, perhaps, just don't give me one right now. As if God asked us how fruitful we want to be, or what our crosses should look like. But what few mention is that that football player I referenced at the beginning of the sermon, his last six children are with his wife, his first wife, within the holy estate of matrimony. That certainly changes things, doesn't it? From God's point of view, but from the world, that's still too many kids, too high of number. But I ran across something that his wife wrote, the football player's wife. She said, some don't understand our blessings and become unappreciative. But separated from the word of God, the devil confuses. Today I'm thankful for all my blessings because I know God never makes mistakes. What a good confession. We certainly make mistakes, but God in creating life does not. People love to talk about numbers, but a child is not a number. He is a life that God has created. And so are you. Every child is a special creation of God. And And Jesus loves that child. He laid down his life for that child. Baptism, the application of salvation, is for that child. He's a part of all nations. God loves children even when we don't, because they're His. He is the one who made them. But false gods get more worship than the true God, and more respect than the creation of life that God has made. And everyone has a reason for denying life, and possibly even murdering. I don't have time. I have a job. I don't have money. I don't want that many hardships. These are what people serve and worship instead of the true God. A single doctor killed over 1,200 babies in 1 year here in Omaha, not too long ago. Should our God be pleased with our city and give us a pat on the back? There's outrage over one drive-by shooting, but not thousands of murders each year of the worst kind right here. And this violence is worse in many ways. It's not from a stranger, but from fathers and mothers that God blesses. For the mother's body was meant to protect fragile life, but it has become the fierce battleground. And millions of bodies litter our nation's record and stain it with guilt. For that was not God's intention. God, who made women to be mothers, not to be brutal executioners. Blessed is everyone who fears the Lord, who walks in His ways. Your wife will be like a fruitful vine within your house. Your children will be like olive shoots around your table. Behold, thus shall the man be blessed who fears the Lord. But a doctor, they had trouble finding doctors to kill babies here in Omaha, said a doctor from the East Coast that would fly in to perform these operations and this murder. And she said, this is an essential service for women that they need and they want. No doubt sinners want bad things that are evil and hateful, but do they need it? Only if motherhood, if life itself, stands in their way as the enemy. For men and women are obviously not equal physically. Our bodies were created quite distinct. It's one of the most obvious things in the world that men and women were designed for different tasks and roles for marriage. And to treat them the same is to ignore God's creation and design. For women can do one thing men cannot, no matter how hard they try. Only women can bear life. And so denying motherhood and its sacrifices becomes godlike to those seeking to be the same as men. And then God's order isn't done. Marriage is not seen as a one-flesh union with distinct yet completely compatible roles that fit together in a divine way, but as two equal people having their own lives, getting their own way. But only a homosexual relationship contains two true equals that are built for the same role and to do the same things. And they produce no children. And that's why homosexuality and its evil perversion is the ideal romantic relationship of our world. It denies God's order. It denies His created roles and the biology that He made us with. And it prevents life. No children can come from that sin. But God was not depriving women by saying that men should be pastors, should lead in society, in church, and in the family. No, Christ was trying to protect women with the role that He made for them. But where men do not take up that role, where they are weak, passive, and submissive, women have to be strong for them. And they can be. But who suffers? Children and motherhood in general. God said the husband is the head of his wife. But He made that position so that He can protect and honor and love her. For marriage and sex is not equal for men and women. God did not design it that way. never have to give birth. I will never have contractions. I will never have to wear elastic pregnancy panties. Now, women are affected very unequally by marriage. So in pretending there is equality, marriage and children must be sacrificed to the idol of their gods, must be shoved in the corner. And that is why the blood of many children flow from clinics around our nation, staining our nation with guilt. So God is not pleased. Blood must be answered for. But yet, you are not guiltless either. Do you always see life as a blessing, even in very difficult circumstances? Even when kids don't have the sort of family and place to live that we would like? Do you value your comfort, your career, your income more than God's will? Do you love the American God of equality more than God's word? We have to go back to the beginning. And what did God say? It is not good that man should be alone. I will make a helper fit for him. Therefore, man shall leave his father and mother and hold fast to his wife, and they shall become one flesh. Without this order, marriage crumbles. Society falls apart. We can see it all around us. And sexual sin dominates. Women are seen as mere objects, not people uniquely made by Christ for a holy purpose. And so women should not demand equality. We hear that cry today. They should demand much more. They should demand a greater honor, as befits their unique role of doing something that no man can do. Likewise, husbands, live with your wives in an understanding way, showing honor to the woman as the weaker vessel, since they are heirs with you of the grace of life, so that your prayers may not be hindered. Salvation is the same, but our earthly roles are not, unless God made a mistake in making us. But you cannot confess someone else's sin. But we have our own sin, our own worry, our own hardened hearts. We think, how will I care for myself and my family? But you did not make yourself or your children. The Lord Almighty did. And God certainly gives daily bread to everyone without our prayers, even to all evil people. Do you see your guilt? Do you see your false gods clearly? How dare you accuse the Lord of stinginess, of not thinking about the future? Doesn't he know all things? No, it is we, not him, who are evil and unloving. We deserve to be condemned to death. We deserve to be ripped to pieces by the holy God, the very thing our world does to the unborn, and then celebrates. The solution to your sin, the solution to all the evil that we see around us, is not in you. It was born for Christ. God in the flesh was conceived by the Spirit. He entered your world to face your sin. And he had to be born just like you were. Mary was unsure about this birth as a virgin. She said, how will this be since I'm a virgin? And Mary was not saved by carrying Jesus and giving birth to him. She had to trust in him and live by faith that he was her sin offering. But she had one of the greatest honors in the world. She got to grow God's body within her. Jesus, the Lamb for the world. For this is the only way that life comes, and Jesus came just like we did. And without Mary's role as a mother, there would be no sacrifice for sin. There'd be no gospel. Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. This favor, though, this blessing, required real sacrifice for Mary. And do you think it made Joseph happy to be newly married with a pregnant wife who had to remain a virgin? But Mary was given the word of the Lord. The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be called holy, the Son of God. This child is what we should look to. Don't look to your own grace for salvation. They are not holy, they need forgiveness. But her response, what Mary says, is appropriate for all Christians. It is the response of faith. Behold, I am the servant of the Lord. Let it be to me according to your word. So we don't need to impress Jesus. He's already died for us. We simply serve as ungrateful servants. Women have a special honor that men do not get. And they are naturally more passive in the way that life comes. But without women sacrificing their bodies as mothers, there would be no one to baptize, no one to preach to. But Christians do not have to pretend to be holy. We do not hide our sins behind fake smiles. You are forgiven. And so the Lord will not hurt you. He will not reject you. And life is much more than the troubles and aches and pains we face right now. We have God's will. Who cares for you? And so we may even pray to our God as our Father, and He listens to us, because He loves us in Christ. You have all of God's will and favor in the one who was born to face your sins in a human body just like yours. In Jesus' blood, we have redemption, the forgiveness of sins. But don't compare yourself to your neighbor. It's not a contest. The Lord gives you enough to do in divine faith. Accept what He gives you as good and holy in Christ. For God's will is all that we need, knowing that He will not hurt us. In fact, He has an eternal place He's preparing for us as we go through these struggles presently. Live by His goodness and be a man or woman as He created you. For there is nothing more Christian than honoring God in your body. So imitate Mary, saying, let it be to me according to your word. And He speaks also in creation. And this faith alone brings righteousness, that not even bearing 1,000 children could bring. For Jesus alone is our righteousness, the one born for us. That doctor who was flying to Omaha is very passionate about her God. She flies all over the country murdering the unborn. But where is our love? Where is our enthusiasm? Where is our welcoming of life? Why are we so cold and indifferent, and people who hate life are so passionate and willing to work and sacrifice everything? We talk about children as if they were a TV to buy for a home. Do murderers have more belief and passion in their gods than we do in the true God? Let it not be. We need God's word just like Mary to make us alive, to help us be able to love God and accept His will. It's not within us. We need this news to rebirth us to God in Christ's righteousness so that we can submit to His loving will and headship in all things. For this is how holy women who hoped in God used to adorn themselves, by submitting to their own husbands, as Sarah obeyed Abraham, calling him Lord. And you are her children if you do good and do not fear anything that is frightening. It is quite tough for women to be godly women in submission and motherhood unless men are first true men. Fatherhood is a lot different than motherhood, but every dad has a holy task to lead, to raise Christians. Fathers are to discipline, to ensure that the true doctrine is taught, to take charge of prayer. And man, as the head, is never disconnected from his wife, and so there are unlimited opportunities to love, to honor, and protect. And without this headship, motherhood and children are just woman's problems. No wonder so many people think women. No, so many women think children are the enemy that must be slaughtered. But Joseph, though he was put in a very difficult situation, did not abandon Mary. He did not say, Jesus is my child, he's not my problem. No, he was given a wife to love and protect, to be her head. So be content with the body and the station the Lord put you in. The Lord wants you to have a new heart, to love His will, accept whatever He gives is good. After all, He has made you His child for eternity. The one who gave His only Son cares for all His children. Amen. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, guard and keep your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. Amen.